Hi, I'm Dylan with Mastercam. One of the common challenges of working with CAD surfaces is dealing with controlling or changing the underlying UV grid that defines the surface. Traditionally, working with a toolpath that directly utilizes the surface UVs of the model, such as 3D flow line or multi-axis flow, can be difficult if the surface UVs don't follow the shape of the part geometry. In the past, re-sweeping the surface entirely was a common tool to get the exact UV flow desired for programming, but this was labor-intensive. Let's explore two new surfacing tools in Mastercam 2021 aimed at this problem, Edit UV and Reflow UV. I'd like to apply a flow toolpath to the colored channel on this sorting slider. To that end, I've created surfaces from the solid on level 25. If I change model shading to wireframe, the wireframe view shows the UV grid pattern on each of these surfaces. I can see I have some alignment problems on at least one of the surfaces. I'll turn the view back to shaded and launch one of the new surfacing tools, Edit UV. I'm prompted to select the surfaces I want to edit. In this case, I'll simply select all of them here. Once I complete this, I get a gridded display of the surface UVs along with vector directions for each surface. I can see I have more problems with this surface set than I originally thought, because while some surface grids look aligned, their U and V directions were perpendicular to each other. While in Edit UV, I can graphically change any of the surface UVs by interacting with the UV gnomon. Clicking on the respective U or V arrows will reverse their direction. Clicking on the center of the UV gnomon will flip the U and V directions between each other. If we look at the Edit UV panel controls, we see that we have the same UV reverse and flip options with the three buttons on the left. We also have a button, Propagate, to match UV alignment across all selected surfaces. This is a very powerful button when working with surface sets. I'll choose Propagate UVs, then select the bottom center surface as the seed surface. Immediately, all surface UV directions are reflowed based on my seed surface. Note all the U and V gnomon changes, and especially the grid changes that you can see in the fillets. We could launch right into a flow path from here and have a usable surface set. Even though my surfaces have been reflowed, we didn't make any major edits to the way the UV grid is patterned across these surfaces. What that means is that we have an area of mismatch between the lower and upper channel floor that could still stand to be improved. Let's close Edit UV and we'll launch the Reflow UV command to address this. With Reflow UV, we only work with a single surface at a time, but we have much more power over that surface than we do with Edit UV. With Rotation Angle active on the Reflow UV panel, let's select the upper floor surface. Upon selection, I get the UV grid, and I also get a rotation control on the gnomon. I can select the control and rotate the entire UV grid freeform, or type in an angle value if I want. We want to do a more complex edit to this surface than just a grid angle change, so I'll change the reflow type to boundary curves. This brings up a chaining dialog. We can select up to four chains to act as boundaries to reflow the surface. I'll turn on level 26, where I have some prepared boundary chains, and select the purple, green, blue, and yellow chains. For the purple chain, I'll use the chaining endpoint arrow to move the endpoint along through the three wireframe entities I'm using as part of this chain. The end result of the reflowed surface more closely matches the lower floor at the surface joints and respects the left edge boundary with the fillet rather than just being a trimmed version of a square flowed grid. Without remaking any of the original surfaces, I prepared the entire surface set for clean and efficient flow machining paths. Edit UV and Reflow UV are two more powerful options for working with surfaces in Mastercam 2021.